before hitting the welcome y'all back to another vlog. And I'm taking me a walk, but I really wanted to give y'all this review on these Yeezy Butters. As y'all can see the bags right here. So as I walk back to my place, I give y'all a quick review on it, because I don't really want to be too long on this review, because if you seen one Yeezy, you seen them all. And I mean, it is what it is on that. People are always talking about resale is dead and all this and all that. I mean, look, there's still a market for people to buy. There's still a market for sellers to sell. You just gotta know how to play your pick and choose and play your cards right. But yeah, I get back with y'all and I'm gonna give y'all the dope ass, the little quick review on this shoe.
You dig?
Which one?
That one. Eventually get some of these. I'm loving these things, man. It's Kyrie boys. I'ma get these. I really am gonna get these. Got a few things still sitting. I might need to just pull the trigger and buy these. Balaga. Now, I don't remember seeing that inside label right there on the last couple of ones. But as you can see, butter. Size 11. Retail on the ones. I don't even have the retail thing. You used to have it right here too. But the retail on these were 220. So it came out to about 240 with tax. Paper is that traditional wax paper, and as you can see, you got the shoe down. Pull the other one out too. Alright. But as y'all can see, bam. Now, to be honest, it does remind you a lot of the. Looks like a vintage version of the creams. But as you can see, you got the two. Butter, you got the butter laces, the butter pull tab, but at the bottom you have a really light gum outsole on here. As you can see the texture, I'm trying to make that out for you, get the light. There we go. As y'all can see right there, got the texture right there on the boost. Y'all can see there. Nah, the camera might not be picking it up, but this is actually a real, like, this is yellow. This is yellow, and I think, yeah, the lighting is not doing it no justice, but this thing is yellow. As you can see on the back, got that gum going toward the off-center tab. Have this butter yellow going all the way around. As you can see on the stripe usually there's a stripe right there, and there is no supply branding on this at all, like supply 350 or anything. It just blank. Let's go to the other side, look at that stitch going up the middle. On the other side, the medial, nothing major. Again, that pull tab, and they don't even have like the dots that usually go along with that pull tab. Inside, you have the three stripe brand and 3M still, and you also have that Yeezy Adidas brand on the insole. And the bottom of this, it used to be gray, if I'm not mistaken. You can see it's white, a few little dots on there. But other than that, I mean, it's just like every other Yeezy that we done picked up throughout the year, man. Throughout the years. And I've had enough of them to know to be able to spot a fake pair now. But yeah, man, I mean, nothing to really go off too major with it. I mean, like I said, I got 3-4 pairs, sold them all, and like, it is what it is. I mean, people keep talking about resale on these shoes. I mean, quantity makes a whole difference when it comes to resale. Like, everybody wants to have some kind of exclusivity with these shoes and stuff. Hope y'all enjoyed it, man. As always, man, stay true, stay fly, stay blessed, and I will see you. Ooh, wait, hold up. Oh, I almost thought I seen the supply 350 right there on this one. Look, I'm about to end the video and not show y'all the other shoe. Matter of fact, I almost forgot about the hang tag on there. As y'all can see, got the Japanese, UK, Hong Kong, France, and this is even different on here now too. Yeah, they did change the labeling up a little bit on these. It's right there. But again, man, like I said, as always, man, stay true, stay fly, stay blessed, and I'll see y'all on the next video. And I am JC Baby, and I'm out. You did.